Welcome along then to the Belgian Grand Prix, the race that gave us the maiden victory for the Jordan team in 1998. And in the same team, the phenomenal debut of a young Michael Schumacher. There's always something special around one of the many corners of this fan favourite circuit. Spa-Francorchamps then, a historic 19-corner circuit with a lap distance of 4.35 miles. There's over 100 metres of elevation change here, and with long stretches of the lap spent flat out, a good top speed will be vital for success. Anthony Davidson also joins me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Garcia. They're starting towards the back of the field. So they'll be disappointed, won't they?
They'll have a sinking feeling as they look up from the cockpit and realise they're in a different postcode to the start line for sure. But the one positive they can hold on to is that the car is quick and they can make their way through the field.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Perez, Albon, Sainz, Ricciardo, and Lance Stroll, Norris, Gasly, Daniel Kvyat, and Magnussen, Raikkonen, Hubert, George Russell, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Latifi, Grosjean. They've taken a grid penalty. Garcia and Esteban Ocon rounds off the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
looked bad. Are you all right? Let me know you're all right.
Strategy options.
see these tyres through to the end now.
Thank you. arrive soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine on.
Thank you.
doubted whether they could pull off the win here at Spa-Francorchamps, but they've done so in spectacular style. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy and to stay out of trouble.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. After today's performance, Valtteri Bottas secures the championship lead. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
That's got to be the flying fin. Wait, how many flying fins have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed and a good job in traffic as well.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts. You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy? You lost to your teammate today. Was it just not your day? Do you have any comments about the collisions? Everything.